Hello everyone, my today's lecture will be on progressive resistance exercises part 3. So what are the benefits of progressive resistance exercises? It enhances the muscle performance, it increases the strength of the connective tissues like tendons, ligaments and intramuscular connective tissue. Greater bone mineral density or less bone demineralization. So it increases the bone mineral density. It decreases the stress on joints during physical activity, reduced risk of soft tissue injury during physical activity, possible improvement in capacity to repair and heal damaged soft tissues due to positive impact on the tissue remodeling, possible improvement in balance, enhances the physical performance during daily living and other recreational and occupational activities. Positive changes in the body composition is also seen due to PRE. It increases the lean muscle mass and decreases the body fat. Enhanced feeling of physical well-being, possible improvement in perception of disability and quality of life. So these are the benefits of progressive resistance exercises. So muscle fiber types and resistance to fatigue. So type 1, type 2A and type 2B. So resistant to fatigue is the first characteristic. Type 1 fibers have high resistance to fatigue, type 2A have intermediate resistance to fatigue and type 2B has low resistance to fatigue. Capillary density, type 1 and type 2B fibers have high and type 2B has low capillary density. Energy system, type 1 and type 2A uses aerobic energy system and type 2B uses anaerobic energy system. Diameter, type 1A is having small diameter, type 2A fibers are having intermediate and type 2B has large diameter. Twitch rate, only type 1 fibers are having slow twitch rate while type 2A and 2B has fast twitch rates. Maximum muscle shortening velocity, type 1 has slow velocity, type 2A has fast velocity and type 2B has fast velocity. What are the signs and symptoms of muscle fatigue? When the patient is performing progressive resistance exercises, it is important to look at the signs and symptoms of fatigue. So the signs and symptoms are uncomfortable sensation in the muscle, even pain can be there and muscle cramping can be there. Tremors can be there in contracting muscle. Active movements can be jerky and it cannot be smooth. Inability to complete the movement pattern through the full range of available motion during dynamic exercises. Use of substitute motion, that is incorrect movement pattern to complete the movement pattern. Inability to continue low intensity physical activity and decline in peak torque during isokinetic testing. So these are the signs and symptoms of muscle fatigue. What are the physiological adaptation to progressive resistance exercises? So for they have given in two components. One is strength training adaptation and another is endurance training adaptation. Skeletal muscle structure, hypertrophy of muscle fiber is seen great in type 2 fibers, and in endurance training also hypertrophy is seen, but it is minimal or there can be no change. Hyperplasia is seen, and then capillary bed density decreases and mitochondrial density and volume also decreases. In case of endurance training adaptation, capillary bed density increases, mitochondrial density and volume also increases. In case of neural system adaptation, due to strength training, motor unit recruitment increases, rate of firing also increases and synchronization of firing also increases due to strength training program. In case of metabolic system, ATP storage increases, myoglobin storage also increases. And in case of endurance training also ATP and myoglobin storage increases. Enzymes, creatine phosphokinase increases, myokinase also increases, and similar effects are also seen in case of endurance training. Body composition, so in lean body, that is fat free mass increases and body fat percentage decreases due to strength training. Lean body, that is fat free mass, there can be no change also, and percentage of body fat decreases in case of endurance training. Connective tissue, tensile strength of tendons, ligaments and connective tissue in muscle increases. BMD also increases. In case of endurance training adaptation, tensile strength of tendons, ligament also increases. Increased mineralization with weight bearing activities. So what are the general principles of progressive resistance exercises? There are basically three principles. The first one is examination and evaluation. The second one is preparation for resistance exercise. And the third one is application of the resistance exercise. So as you can see in this slide, in examination we have to take the patient history, we have to assess the patient for strength, we have to take range of motion for each and every patient, we have to see their functional evaluation, RM, that is repetition maximum, has to be determined by the therapist, progress also should be determined, and dosage and type of the exercise should be decided by the therapist. The second component is the preparation component. In preparation, we have to prescribe the exercise. We have to see whether there is availability of proper equipment or not. Clothing, unrestricted clothing should be worn by the patient. Shoes also should be fitting in size. Firm support should be there. And therapist has to demonstrate the exercise to the patient. In case of application, first we have to start with the warm-up. Then placement and direction of resistance should be decided. Stabilization of the other part should be done. Intensity, volume also can be decided. Verbal command should be given by the therapist. Then therapist has to monitor the patient while the patient is performing the exercises. And the entire session should be followed by the cool down period. So what are the precautions that we have to take during the PRE? So keep the ambient temperature of the exercise setting. Then pain should not occur during the exercises. Do not initiate resistance training at a maximal level of resistance. Avoid using heavy resistance. Do not apply resistance across an unstable joint. If joint instability is there, then do not give resistance exercises. Have the patient avoid breath holding during resistance exercise to prevent the Valsalva maneuver, and emphasize exhalation during exertion. Avoid uncontrolled ballistic movement during the exercises. Prevent incorrect or substitute motion during exercise. Avoid exercises that place excessive stress on the joints. And be aware of medication a patient is using that can alter the acute and chronic responses to exercise. Avoid cumulative fatigue due to excessive frequency of exercise. And discontinue exercises if the patient experiences pain, dizziness, or unusual shortness of breath. So all these things are noticed, then we have to stop the exercise. Contraindication, what are the contraindication? There are mainly three. First one is pain. If severe joint pain or muscle pain is there, then pain cannot be eliminated by reducing the resistance, then stop the exercise. Inflammation can, in case of inflammatory condition, PRE can again irritate the joint and cause more inflammation, like in case of GBS and poliomyelitis. Severe cardiopulmonary disease, 12 weeks after myocardial infarction or coronary artery bypass grafting surgery, or the patient or until the patient has clearance from a physician. So if the patient is having any underlying cardiopulmonary disease, then the clearance should be taken first from the physician, then only we can start with the PRE. So for today's video, the reference is the book Therapeutic Exercise, Caroline Kissner, 5th edition. So this is the picture. In this picture, the doctor is saying that when I was a kid, I wanted to be a superhero. You have become one. COVID cases. So we are saluting all the frontline warriors, the doctors, the nurses, the paramedical staff, police, the government, and all the people who are fighting against this COVID-19 outbreak. And let's hope and pray for the country. Thank you for watching this video. If you have enjoyed watching this video, then subscribe my channel, like this channel, and share with your friends. Thank you.